Despite the increase of cyber attacks in recent years, few companies still commit to in-house cybersecurity investments. But the paradox comes from organizations which sell cybersecurity solutions to third parties, but their internal systems are dated or deficient. It is well known that digital exposes our data to great risk, and chief information security officers, CISO, should raise awareness among leaders on the issue, where prevention is definitely better than cure. In fact, they are well aware of improper corporate data protection risks. However, when CISOs have to explain them to business leaders, they often mistake using complex terms or dwelling on the technical part at the expense of the practical part. The benefits to the company in terms of economics and business impact are evident, and this is why it is important to take action from the first presentation of a cybersecurity solution. Keep watching the video to discover the four aspects to focus on. Ready? Let's get started. When we sit around the table, whether it's an internal meeting with the cybersecurity department or whether the expert is an outside consultant, we must establish a relationship of trust, especially if we decide to outsource the protection of a company's most important value: confidential data and information. The person speaking will need to convey trust first through nonverbal communication, and then a concrete, clear, and comprehensive presentation. Cybersecurity software is not a one-time product, but a lasting solution. Therefore, the relationship that is established between the team and the executives must be strong. The CEO doesn't want to listen to a monotone talk about the qualities of a solution or technical aspects that don't know how they will affect the entire organization. The slides or material created for the meeting should be tailored to the potential customer using its data and internal processes. Better if, instead of cold data and statistics, a story is used as per storytelling technique to lower that reality into a hypothetical risk situation. Taking, for example, a cross-departmental figure, one can simulate a hypothetical hacker attack during usual activities, showing how easy it is to be fooled by an email that simulates internal conversations, make the danger concrete. And I would love to know, do you have any experience with that? So if so, feel free to comment below with your thoughts, and if you are enjoying the video, well, why not? Put a like as well. Whether the company has an in-house IT security department or relies on an outside consultant, the solution will involve all departments and employees. The business leader must understand that cyber risk management strategy is not the sole responsibility of the IT department. Confidential and sensitive data affect the entire company, and it is not enough to implement software. You have to train employees and show them the possible threats and what to do when an attack alert appears, but also how to enable protection on some data and exclude others. In short, technology offers opportunities and facilitates the process, but protection needs responsible behavior and an awareness that every employee will have to achieve. What is the key element that every entrepreneur will want to know? Right after the economic investment is made, time is another crucial variable. If you have to involve all departments, you definitely want to know how long they will have to pause their activities, how long the training will last, but also what the impact will be on the entire business ecosystem. Addressing digital threats requires the creation of a true cybersecurity ecosystem that incorporates technology, financial investment, organization, and human resource skills. In order to make decisions involving a high degree of accountability, well, business leaders will need to ensure there is cross-sector collaboration. Spreading a culture that is attentive to corporate security means thinking along these lines in both the strategic and the tactical phases, reserving a part of each sector's planning for cybersecurity. The consultant or an internal CISO will need to help leaders understand that to create an ecosystem that works, it is necessary to move from awareness of adequate data protection to a security culture. It will therefore be necessary to draft a cyber risk assessment, which identifies the areas of greatest risks, provides specifically designed solutions for data protection, detects any bugs or threats, and defines the cyber emergency response plan, namely how to respond to attacks and procedures for data recovery. To bring this process back to all company areas, it will be necessary to train resources based on their activities and provide them with the required skills to proceed independently by incorporating security techniques into their tasks. The real focus of the meeting is the financial part of the investment to be undertaken and the data showing the impact such an implementation would generate in the company. Managers and board members need to know all the variables that affect the risks and opportunities related to security to understand the operation's real value. And in addition, it will be critical to know the time frame for action so that funding is adequate and timely. In the exposition, CISO will need to highlight metric useful in protecting information, monitoring systems and verifying human behavior, proactive measures that will mitigate any threats, long-term strategies, including objectives, technology and service investments, and return on investment. The impact of implementation on internal procedures, installation time, training, and how it will change business operations. What the operational, management, and maintenance costs will be over time. If business leaders fully understand the severity and risks of a cyber attack in their company, they will listen carefully to this phase. Indeed, losing customer data and stopping production or operations because of a systems attack are significant image and economic costs. If few companies are willing to take the risk, it's because they are unaware or because they don't really understand the entire process. And by the way, if you would like to discover more about cyber attacks inside companies, I suggest you give a glimpse to my video right here in the corner, which is focused on that. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. And if it is so, feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel as more content will come shortly. Plus, click on the bell to make sure you receive a notification directly whenever I publish a new video. See you soon. Ciao.